Hello, beautiful blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpine. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. Let's check the prices of the major cryptocurrencies according to the site of CoinGecko. And as we see, most of the major cryptocurrencies, they have recorded a solid price increase for the last 24 hours. And I am really very happy when I see that the cryptocurrencies continue to increase in price when the prices of the major cryptocurrencies and of course and of the alternative coins have been in the green zone for the last 7 days. This is something great. And I want to say that yesterday was Monday, so I analyzed the price chart of Bitcoin. Today is Tuesday, that's why I'm going to analyze the price chart of Ethereum. This is the price chart of Ethereum. The current price is $1,375. Ethereum has increased solidly for the last 12 months, so this is the linear chart. Now let's move on to the candlestick chart. So this is the candlestick chart. Of course, I will start from the monthly time frame. Let me just choose a better chart, I would say. So probably we have to take the price chart of Coinbase. Okay, that's it. Now let me remove the unnecessary elements and we're ready to start. So this is how it looks like. This is the monthly time frame. We have a sequence of bullish candlesticks with ascending local lows and ascending local highs. This is a bullish signal. Also, if we take into account the current bullish candlestick, it is a massive one. If it remains by the end of the month like this, I would say this is a solid bullish signal. But we have to understand that we still have 12 days and a half more, that's why the situation may change. But once again, if we have something like this, I would say this is a nice solid bullish signal. Also, let's have a look at the previous local low, the all time, let's say still the all time high back in 2017. Actually, this is the very beginning of 2018. And what I want to say is if we take this horizontal level, the very important one that I've been talking about many, many times, that is equal to the closing price of this candlestick for the January of 2018 and equal to the opening price of this red candlestick or the bearish candlestick for the month of February in 2018 when the bear market started. This is this critical level. Now we see that the price has surpassed significantly that key level, and once again, if we have a candlestick like this with a closing price significantly above this level, that will be a very solid bullish signal. Of course, we have this volatility here, so this tall upper shadow, but if we switch to a linear chart, it will disappear. And actually, this is the previous, let's say, reliable, I would say, local high. We're above that local high already. So 12 more days and we have, if we have a price chart like this, that will be really very nice solid bullish signal. Now let's get back to the candlestick chart. So I'm removing this level. Let's move to the weekly chart. This is how it looks like. A sequence of mainly bullish candlesticks with ascending local lows and ascending local highs. Definitely this is a bullish signal. However, I want to mention that last week this very interesting candlestick formed. It's called a hanging man. It has a small body, a very tall lower shadow, and usually traders consider this candlestick to be a potential trend reversal candlestick. However, if it's at the top of some, let's say, if it is forming some local top high. But what I want to say is usually traders, they don't take into account or into consideration just one candlestick. They usually take the next one or the next ones in order to figure out if there is confirmation. Let me just remind you once again about it, because we've been talking a lot about such kind of situation. So if we assume that this is a trend reversal candlestick, then it would be really more reliable signal if the next candlestick is a bearish one with a body engulfing the bodies of the previous candlesticks with a local high below the previous one and a local low that is below the previous one. However, at the moment, we don't have anything similar to such kind of candlestick. Even conversely, we have a bullish candlestick that already has a local high above the previous ones. So this is a bullish signal. And actually, if at the end of the week we have a candlestick like this, definitely it will cancel all this negativity or this slight bearish signal based on this hanging man. That's why it may turn out that this candlestick will be a signal indicating just a period of some consolidation. But once again, let's see what happens by the end of the week. Once again, if we have this bullish candlestick at the end of the week or something like this, that will be a bullish signal and it will cancel completely the negativity coming from this candlestick. Now let's switch to the daily chart. Nothing that interesting here. We can easily see that the price is increasing. Of course, let me a little bit shorten the price chart, and I would like to show you that at the moment we're testing the levels of the previous local high. So that is the all-time high that formed early in 2018. So actually, if we take the highest, let's say, point back then, it was something like, let's say, 1,420 dollars, according to the price chart provided by Coinbase. So we're almost there. We're testing this local high. What I want to say is definitely that local high will serve as some kind of psychological resistance for the bulls nowadays. We have to be really very careful. But let me just remind you that back in December, Bitcoin was able to significantly easily surpass its local high. That's why I'm pretty sure that it's just a matter of time when Ethereum surpasses this level. So yes, it may face a couple of, let's say, pullbacks. We may see some resistance, but definitely no doubt that it will happen. Ethereum will surpass sooner or later that local high. And I'm almost confident 100%. We just need to wait a little bit. That's it. Now, let's switch to the 4-hour chart. So, this is the 4-hour chart. What I want to say is, recently I've been talking about one technical formation here. Actually, this is an ascending triangle. Let me try to draw this ascending triangle. This is how it looks like. This is the ascending triangle. Usually, these ascending triangles, they have more waves, keeping in mind that there was an uptrend before that ascending triangle, and keeping in mind that all those triangles, they are mainly continuation patterns, it means that it is highly probable, because once again it's a continuation pattern, technical pattern, that the price will exit the triangle in the upward direction and it will resume the uptrend. This is highly probable. According to the theory of technical analysis, usually these triangles, they have at least 5 waves. Let me show you what I mean, something like this. So this is the first one, then we have the second one, then we have the third one, then we have a fourth one, and then at least 5 waves, and during the fifth one, the uptrend resumes. What I want to say is, of course, the situation may be a little different, let's say, and we may see even a price exit from the price exits the triangle much earlier, and then we will just have, let's say, something like triangle here, but actually the uptrend may resume much earlier. Anyway, we'll have to keep an eye on the price chart once again. This is just my point of view, and it's up to you. So fellas, that's it for today. Thank you for watching this video. Please share your point of view on the price of Ethereum as a comment under this video. Of course, I wish you a very wonderful day. Good luck in the financial markets, and hope to see you in the next one. It was me again at CryptoSpark.